Come on back, Ido. Hello, can you hear us?
Are you talking to me?
Of course, you can hear us.
Sorry? Tell me.
Can you hear us?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear us?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, welcome. Okay, so I think the slides are facing some problems, so we'll go to the other mode. The basic mode. And, okay. I'm sure you can see the screen. Not really, I guess. Okay. So we were at phase two, that is after phase one of profound study and examination, they moved to phase two, where they would evaluate the available resources that are allotted for human resources of the organization. Next is they would design a HR strategy accordingly as per the study in phase one and phase two. Then at phase four, they would implement the devised strategies that are tailored and devised at phase three. Next is at five, they'll examine the impact, observe the development, identify loopholes and the lacunae, and make amends, relevant changes. Next is performance output, basically is a key indicator of HR strategy here. In addition, examine failures and strategize appropriate corrective action. Next at phase six, they would make amends in the strategy to cover up the lacunae or go even for redesigning the HR strategy or crafting the HR strategy. At stage seven or phase seven, they would implement the amended strategy and continue being vigilant and accommodate amends as the system evolves. Now, what are the HRD tools, the strategic human resource development tools? The first tool is, of course, the tool of manpower planning or strategic human resource planning. Now, strategic manpower planning is done by evaluating the present and future needs of the organization, forecasting manpower needs, keeping in mind the strategic goals of the organization, conducting a manpower audit of the current workforce, and strategizing to improvise them. The next tool would be the tool of, strategic workers participation tool, or SWP. That is, I'm going to the third one. So they would devise an effective workers participation tool as a collaborative technique to pool knowledge and engage them in information sharing, research, share ideas to collaborative projects, especially designated team tasks. Next is the SPAT tool. The SPAT tool is a strategic performance appraisal technique, which is an alliance with human resource management team. I'm not talking about the second point here. They would strategize empowering employees by training schemes that aim at sharpening their skills and those skills which are required for the job, within the company, educating them and developing their potential by acquainting them to the developments in the sector at a global level. And they'll strategize to empower them with adequate training and knowledge to build resilience to future corporate challenges that may or may not be foreseen, and build corporate allegiance to achieve the present and future goals of the organization. So therefore, what's required here is using the SPAT tool well by integrating organizational, even career development, integrated as within even the SPAT tool to encourage better productivity. So we have spoken about manpower, manpower building or manpower planning as a tool, or human resource planning as a tool. Next is a SPAT tool, that is a strategic performance appraisal technique. Or next is the strategic workers participation, SWP tool. Next is the organizational development tool. Near the organizational development tool, or the OD tool, what they would do here is they would incorporate the OD tool in strategic implementation of HRD plan. For example, they would encourage employees in participative planning, peace building, work in collaboration or collaborative participation. They would normally encourage it. Next is communication tool. They would devise a good mechanism that encourages transparent communication within the departments and structure, all working towards achievement of a single goal, that is emphasized corporate goal. Next is open door counseling. Now again, the open door policy, I'm sure you know it, open door policy, open door counseling, normally engaging in counseling in case of any conflicts or minor employer-employee spats or employer-employee differences. So encourage healthy confrontation and build trust. Next is corporate grievance redressal mechanism, which normally a good corporate structure must and should have a good corporate grievance redressal mechanism or grievance redressal mechanisms or grievance redressal mechanism systems. Now, they need to devise a strategic grievance redressal model that will settle conflicts and nip the matters in the bud and retard conflicts from progressing into disputes. I'm sure you know that conflicts are at the initial level where there is friction between the employees or even sometimes between the employer and the employees. So they are at the frictional stage. So there are minor conflicts that might pop up. So these minor conflicts or conflicts are in general, they need to be, really cut off, or they need to be, pruned, and they need to be nipped in the bud. So, and the conflicts need to be retarded so as to discourage it from progressing to a dispute. Because when it reaches to a dispute level, there is a possibility that the worker may, may go in for, or the employee may go in for an external mode of redressing his dispute. So a good strategic grievance redressal mechanism or a model is a must within every organization, and not ignore grievances of the employees. Next is fortified industrial relations. Industrial relations is normally in terms of workers and relationship with workers, and normally within workers' unions, basically. That's depends upon country to country, whether they encourage trade unions or workers' unions. It depends upon the type of the company, type of organization, large-scale organizations, a huge industry. Sometimes there is industrial workers' union, sometimes just a workers' union within a particular company. It depends upon the type of the company, the size of the company, or even industry at the industrial level. So fortified industrial relation, a good HRD department, and a good HR strategic HR management department, would normally see that there is fortified industrial relations, and which is based on, normally they would aid in building industrial relations, which is based on mutual trust and goodwill, but augmenting the confidence of the workers in the management of the company, and vice versa. That is even augmenting the confidence of the management in the workers. Next is enhance the workers' conditions and environment. This is also a tool, a good tool in HRD process, or HRD, is one of the instruments, is like where they enhance the working conditions and the environment, like strategize provisions of a good and a clean and a healthy environment. Think about the infrastructure, decent canteens, game area, recreation area, rest area, seating arrangements, crèches if needed, and where the women can bring their infants or even babies to the organization and keep them at the care of someone who is managing the creche within a company and so on. So if need be within the policy, if these creches are within the policy of a company. So basically, they should also put their mind into developing the infrastructure or in a way that it would benefit the employees, a clean environment, a hygienic environment, a safe environment. Safety is important. And, decent canteens, quality food, then game areas or recreational areas, seating arrangements, clean and, which is also sometimes good to the eye, catchy to the eye. So all these things normally it boosts the confidence of the employee, and it also boosts their productivity level. Next is research tool, participate in research and development and implement improvised processes. Next is the HRD department itself. That is the 11th point I'm talking about. The HR department itself is like a tool. Why itself? A well-established HR department serves as a valuable instrument for achieving strategic human resource development goals and intermingle with organizational needs and goals. Next is the QWLB tool. Now, this tool, that is, there's a need to devise a strategic quality work-life balance tool and then implement it among the employees. So these are some of the tools we've learned about, the phases and the tools in this chapter. Next is thereby the strategic melange of the HRD tools, the intermingling, the melange or the union or looking at it as a compositively, as a unit, the strategic melange of the HRD tools, the HRD processes, HRD outcomes. We learned about outcomes, we learned about process, we learned about the tools, reminiscent of organization goals, that is never forgetting the organization goals, always keeping the organization goals in mind. This aspect, the strategic melange of HRD tool, the HRD processes, strategic HRD outcomes, keeping in mind the organization goals, this contributes towards overall organization productivity and achievement of both long-term and short-term organization goals. And this is what is important in any organization. And again, if you see achievement of long-term and short-term goals, I mean, that is a purpose for the existence of the organization, that they are for, meeting particular goals. They have a goal, and so they have established the organization. So therefore, there is a need of integrating, or there is a need of strategic melange of strategic HRD tools, strategic HRD processes, which would lead to good strategic HRD outcomes. All these mixed together, it should be, mindful of organization goals and contribute towards overall organization productivity and achievement, and goals to achieve both long-term and short-term organizational goals. So this is all for today's class. Your assignments, just be mindful of your assignments, and because that carries marks as well. It carries a huge chunk of marks. I would encourage you to, render your assignments on time. And of course, your exams are fast approaching. Prepare yourselves. And if you have any questions, of course, you can ask me now. If not, just give me your attendance. So there are five of you. Abdirazak Ali Omar.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, okay. Ali Hassan.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Deborah.
Yes, madam.
Okay. Medino.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Abreza, Deborah. Saeed Mohammed.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Can you just put one of you, can you just put these names on on WhatsApp group? Deborah, Abdirazak. Okay, Deborah, Medino, Abdirazak, Ali Hassan, and Saeed Mohammed. Who can do it for me? Any one of you? Deborah, can you just put it in the group?
Yes.
Thank you so much. I'll expect it. I hope you can do it like immediately now. So your attendance would be for five of you. Yes, Deborah, Abdulrazak, Ali Hassan, Medina, and Syed Mohammed Abdi.
I have taken a screenshot. I've put a screenshot already there.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I will check out for this class. So, okay then. God bless you and see you next Wednesday, same time.
Before that, I want to ask you a question.
Sorry?
I want to ask you a question.
Yeah, you want to talk to me. Tell me.
Okay, I hope that you can hear me. I hope that the deadline of the assignment will be 17th June.
You are audible. You're talking about assignments, right? Can you be a little louder, please?
Of course, the deadline of the assignment will be 17th June, right?
Okay, 18th, yes. You're talking about the date of submission, right?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Yeah. Whatever due date is mentioned, you'll have to submit by on that particular date. And when there are delayed submissions, there would be a deduction of 1 mark.
Okay.
Thank you. Yeah, welcome. So I'll expect your assignments on time because it's good for you. And that's a way that you would grab marks. Attendance carries marks as well. So it's good for you that you would, grab whatever possible at this stage. And then later on and go for your exams. Sometimes it's not just about, just passing through the subject. It's good if you put some interest into the subject, study a little well, and you'd gain some good marks. Anyway, it's like how you strategize and what is your goal. No problem, but I'm with you. And if you have any questions, of course, you can ask me anytime. Okay, see you next class. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, goodbye.
Bye.